Imagine an Attack on Titan game incorporating elements from franchises like Battlefield in order to recreate some of the most epic fights from the final season of the anime and manga. Hey everyone, this is your host, Agent Mav, and today I would like to share my idea for an Attack on Titan first-person shooter. This video will contain my own thoughts on what an Attack on Titan first-person shooter could look like, and is not representative of anything actually in development, but I hope you enjoy this video nonetheless. To get started, let me share with you my vision for this game. Like I said earlier, it is mainly designed to replicate battles between Marley and Parodie featuring in Season 4 of the anime and manga, where soldiers collide on the battlefield in large-scale infantry warfare, and Titans dominate the map, decimating anything that stands in their way. Let's start by talking about locations, the battlegrounds where these massive conflicts unfold. Say the game started off by releasing 5 different maps. These could be Fort Slava, Libero, Shores of Parody, The Forest, and Shiganshina. Aside from these maps obviously playing differently, they all have a story to go with them. For example, Eldian forces are deployed to ambush Marleyan troops in Libero, or Marleyan airships launch an air raid on the walled city of Shiganshina. And as the conflict progresses in these maps will change in similar fashion to Levolutions from Battlefield. For the rest of the video, I'm going to be using Libero as my main example. For the raid on Libero, there are obviously two sides, Marley and Eldia, and both factions will play very differently to each other. Whilst Marley has a powerful arsenal of weapons and fortifications at their disposal, not to mention 5 of the 9 Titan Shifters, Eldian troops have the versatility of their ODM gear. At the start of the match, Marleyan troops are caught off guard as Eren Jaeger appears and engages the Warhammer Titan. One player from both sides has an opportunity to take control of a Titan Shifter, and when they die, another person from the same team has a chance to take control. Both sides respond by deploying foot soldiers to engage each other on the ground, whilst these two Titans continue to fight in the center of the map. Players could pick between 4 different classes, like Assault, Heavy, Medic, or Marksman, if you want to make it more akin to Battlefield. When players load in, they'll find a crate on the floor which will equip them with a special loadout exclusive to whatever faction they're playing. Eldians can equip themselves with anti-personnel gear, and Marleyans can wield the deadly anti-Titan rifles. There's only a limited number of these crates, however, so not every player on a team will be equipped with these special loadouts. From here, both teams will engage each other with the sole objective to eliminate as many opponents as they can. As the game progresses, reinforcements will become available to pull in for both teams. These could be crates containing thunder spears, or if you're a Marleyan, maybe you could get kitted out in head-to-toe body armor. Just something cool like that. About halfway into the game, there is a massive event that unfolds, which causes changes to the map. For the raid on Libero, this is of course the destruction of the Marleyan port, where Armin makes his appearance as the Colossal Titan. At this point, I'm sure you see the similarities to Battlefield and Star Wars Battlefront. In fact, I believe you could include some World War I era weapons, purely for the sake of increasing the weapon sandbox. And since Attack on Titan is a fantasy universe, you don't have to be 100% historically accurate. So you could include some new and interesting weapons that we haven't seen before. But now we get into what makes this experience so unique, and why I came up with this idea in the first place. It is of course the ability to control Titans, in the midst of large-scale warfare. Essentially, all the infantry battles revolve around the Titan conflicts. As I'm sure you remember, I said at the beginning, the Warhammer Titan and Eren are already fighting when the game starts. As such, the conflict is drawn to wherever these Titans go on the map. And as a Titan, you can just plow through your surroundings. Every punch, every kick has the ability to knock down entire buildings, so the destruction physics play a big part in this. Because as a soldier, an entire building can come crumbling beside you, and two Titans could come barreling through. So at a certain point in the match, players should have access to more Titan Shifters and other iconic characters from the franchise. If you're a Marleyan, you have the ability to take control of the Warhammer Titan, Zeke, Galliard, Peek, and Reiner, and join the fight as Titans. Each of these Titans have a special set of skills, so allow me to break them down. The Warhammer Titan possesses extremely offensive capabilities, and can manifest weapons that are considerably more powerful than regular melee attacks. However, the downside is, the Warhammer Titan consumes the most stamina of any other Titan, meaning they are less effective in prolonged fights. Zeke is a ranged character, capable of lobbing stones with precision accuracy, or alternatively, scatter stones in a wider area, which is less accurate but extremely useful for clearing out larger groups of enemies. Zeke has a lot of stamina, however is very ineffective in close range combat. Galliard is fast, possessing the most stamina of any other Titan and the ability to leap across the battlefield. He is effective at dealing with soldiers, but less so in one-on-one fights against other Titans due to his small profile. Reiner is a defensive powerhouse, great for absorbing a lot of hits. He is good in one-on-one fights due to his incredible endurance, and in larger conflicts is great for providing a supportive role. And finally, there is Pete, who doesn't engage fights with other Titans, but provides anti-infantry support with a Panzer unit. She can carry up to 4 teammates who can all fire from a mounted machine gun. This makes Pete very efficient at eliminating infantry. Of course, the Eldians aren't helpless, as they too get to call in their own iconic characters, but they are equipped with ODM gear and are specially designed to fight other Titan shooters. Eldians can call in characters like Mikasa, Levi, Kanji, Armin, Jean, Connie, or Sasha, and of course they have Eren, who takes the form of his attack Titan. To make this matchup a bit fairer, considering Marley has 5 Titan shifters compared to Eldia, who has only Eren, only 3 of the 5 can be active at any point in the match. This not only incentivizes teamwork, but also gives Eldians a good chance at taking on the Titan shifters, since they get to call in twice as many troops with ODM gear. And before you ask, no, Armin cannot transform into the Colossal Titan. And whilst these characters fight each other across the map, you have squads of infantry engaged in firefights around them, and that's essentially the whole idea of the game. A character's presence is not subtle either. Titans are big, and every punch, every kick trembles the ground beneath them. Characters with ODM gear soar high above the battlefield, and soldiers are right there in the thick of things, getting caught in the carnage caused by the Titan shifters. Everything should be chaotic as well. Rifle shots should linger in the air, explosions should be emphasized, and Titan roars should be heard across the map. It's the setting of Attack on Titan, a larger-than-life world, and it should be treated as such. Anyway, that's pretty much everything there is to say. I got all my points across, and sure, I could go into detail about gameplay, other modes, maybe some more maps, but, you know, maybe we can leave it up to a part 2, because I would love to go into detail about the raid on Shiganshina. So if you like this video, let me know. And should I do more idea concept videos like this? Because I really did enjoy making this video. Anyway, I'll leave it up to you guys. Until next time, this is Agent Mav, signing off.